We're going to be talking about summer body lotions. If I'm looking a little swollen to you today, you are seeing it right. You know, I wondered whether I should shoot this video or not. Then I was like, you know what? We've got to be real. In the last 2 days, I have not had enough water. When we don't have enough water, the first area that it shows is your eyes. Surprising, right? But it's true. You start feeling your eyes strained, you start feeling them very tired, and you start noticing puffiness. And also, you will notice your face more swollen, because when there's less water, the maximum amount of water that the body hangs on to is on the face. So it's incredibly important, even from a beauty perspective, to have a lot of water, especially now at the summers. I've got a collection of summer lotions, and there are so many summer lotions in the market. The reason I've got these four listed is because all four of them represent a type of category, a type of marketing that we all face day to day when you're buying skincare and products. The first product that I want to talk about is the Pond's Triple Vitamin Lotion, or the Triple Vitamin Silky Smooth Lotion from Pond's. This is a legendary product and it's been used for years and years together. This particular product has got niacinamide, which is of course very good for you, which apart from reducing oiliness and giving you slight amount of fading, is also good for your skin health. Along with that, it's got glycerin, which is of course a humectant, so it traps enough moisture in your skin. There are three ingredients in this particular product that I want to talk about. The first one is sodium ascorbyl phosphate. This is an ester of vitamin C, and so you can expect it to be good for your skin. Vitamin C helps in fading, but also helps build collagen and fights free radicals. Free radicals are pollutants or the sun's radiation or even smoke, cigarette smoke, vehicle smoke that's present in our environment, and it is supposed to go in and really damage your collagen. So it's a good ingredient to look in your summer lotions. It's got so much of slip that a little amount goes a long way and gets beautifully absorbed into your skin. Apart from that, vitamin C also gives you fading. It's known to give you fading, so who doesn't want that, especially when you are somebody who gets tanned very frequently or very easily. It also has vitamin E, just the kind of oil you require for your skin. Whether you have oily skin or dry skin, it's just a great nourisher to have in your skincare. It also has paraffin. Paraffin is supposed to be very, very soothing and very rich emollient for your skin. The reason I shortlisted this is because, one, it's a heritage brand and it is so affordable. The second summer lotion, or the second summer body lotion that I wanted to shortlist, was Kaya Youthful Glow 24-Hour Non-Stop Moisturizing Lotion. The reason I shortlisted this is because there are a lot of people who are prone to a lot of prickly heat or a lot of acne or a lot of, you know, just boils on our body. It happens for a number of reasons. The top reason that it really happens is because we tend to sweat a lot, and the bacteria which is present on our skin anyway, sometimes there's just too much of bacteria and there's too much of food for the bacteria to eat. It's just so much of humidity, which is a perfect ground for bacteria to multiply. We tend to get those boils on our body. This particular lotion has antibacterial properties, and along with that, it also is able to protect your skin barrier. It has a little bit of fragrance, but would do beautifully for someone who has very oily skin, because this doesn't have any mineral oil. Most of the body lotions have mineral oil, which is a perfectly fine ingredient. There's nothing wrong with mineral oil. It's completely safe. You know, it is one of those ingredients that got badmouthed by clean beauty a lot, but it's a very, very safe ingredient to use in your skincare or body care. It has vitamin E, it has got glycerin, it's got niacinamide, and it's got coconut oil. All the great ingredients that you require for looking after your skin. Vitamin E is of course great nutrition. You've got niacinamide, which will not only improve the health of your skin, but also give you a slight amount of fading and control too much of oiliness. So I would think it'll work beautifully for people who have really oily skin. Coconut oil is really packed with fatty acids, and you want that because fatty acids protect your skin barrier. So with all of that protection, it's fantastic for someone who's prone to a lot of acne or a lot of prickly heat in this particular weather, or you know, humid areas that you're living in. This also has the oxygen boost complex that their face wash has, and if you've seen my video on face washes, you'll notice that the moment you use this particular face wash from Kaya, you get that instant brightness on your face. So when you use this, you can expect a lot of help for tanning in prevention, as well as to kind of lighten the tan if you're somebody who's prone to tanning very easily. Personally, for me, my most favorite way of removing tan, keeping my skin smooth and supple, is to use a fresh coffee scrub. I have coffee at home, filtered coffee, so I have the grounds available with me easily. You could just get them off Amazon and grind them. You can add any oil of your choice. I choose between argan oil or primrose oil or even a regular olive oil. The oil you're using only for lubrication as well as slight moisturization and hydration of your skin. And since it is homemade, there is no additional cream or slip in the coffee grounds. So these oils really help. As you can see, these grounds are very thick, so you can expect a really good scrub. And they look coarse, but they're extremely soft on the skin. Because coffee's already been made, these grounds are actually soaked up in water. To that, I also add orange peel, which I grind and keep during the winters. And this powder stays in my fridge and lasts me easily for about 6 to 7 months. And this is all approximation, so I'll add a spoon of it and, you know, just to kind of add to the lightening and the smoothening effect of the scrub. Since the scrub has no fillers, you can expect a really good hydrating and really skin popping scrub. I go over my whole body. I need to warn you that this can get a little messy in the bathroom, but it's just gorgeous for the skin. Especially, you know, highlight areas of your skin, if you tend to wear sleeveless a lot, these kind of areas really can take that extra buffing and shine. After that, I go in with the loofah directly with either liquid soap or even just a bar soap and wash it off. Because the oils are all gentle oils, it's very, very easy to wash off, and you can expect your skin to be beautifully hydrated and glossy. Vaseline, I think, creates the best body lotions hands down among everybody else. I think even Dove and Pond's are very good, but Vaseline just has pure dominance. It has dominance in not only quality, but it also has dominance in the cost. I put down this particular lotion because this promises to bring your body temperature down by 3 degrees when you apply it. Call the Vaseline Ice Cool Hydration for instant cooling. This particular lotion has micro droplets of Vaseline jelly, which kind of smoothen out your skin and give it massive moisturization and massive hydration. Highly recommended for people who have very dry skin or even people who have dry, itchy skin. A lot of times what happens is when you have dry skin, you tend to also get a lot of itchiness because your skin is constantly stretching, and the stretching causes a lot of stress on the skin surface and it causes a lot of itching. So it's going to be very, very good for that. It is also fast absorbing. You know, Vaseline has this dominance in body lotions that they really know what they're delivering for you, right? Everything that you expect from a body lotion, you expect quick absorption, you expect good results, good hydration, good moisturization, non-stickiness, all of that is delivered beautifully in this particular Vaseline lotion. And it kind of cools you down because you can sense the menthol in it. You know, menthol, as you know, is used in a lot of products to kind of give you that cooling sensation. Especially recommended if you have dry skin and you're living in a very humid area. In ingredients, it again has glycerin, it's got niacinamide, it's got menthol to kind of cool you, and it has avobenzone, which is completely safe in skincare. You must be saying, jo pure influencers bol rahe hai, is not good, she comes and says it's completely fine. Well, my research is showing me that it's completely fine, so I'm going to stand by it. It also has linalool and limonene in it, which have been desecrated as bad ingredients in your skincare. They're not bad. Considering they're used in such small quantities, they're not going to harm your skin in any way. Then there is a Good Vibes Liquorice Brightening Body Lotion. And it has got no parabens. I don't know why that is a selling point for any product, because parabens are completely safe in skincare. So this has got, along with licorice, it also has arbutin. So you can expect a lot of fading on your skin if you're somebody who's prone to tanning. And the reason I shortlisted this is because there are lots of lotion out there which do promise you brightening and lightening for your skin, especially in the summer season when we tend to get tanned a lot. What do I say about this product? You know, I've been asked to review Good Vibes for some time, and I get a sense of a product when I'm looking at the brand, I'm looking at the ingredients. I know it's called snap judgment, but you know, when you spend these many years in the skincare or in the beauty market, you kind of get that third sense or that intuition about a product. So I've been trying to stay away from reviewing Good Vibes, but then I got this lotion and I tried to use it. In terms of ingredient, it check marks all the boxes. It's got cucumber extract to keep you cool. It's got licorice to kind of give your skin tanning and brightening. It also has arbutin, which will again make your skin lighter and brighter, which is great when you're trying to get tan out of your body or even trying to prevent tan, right? It also has sandalwood extract and it's got rose extract. So there is a slight pleasant fragrance to it. And sandalwood is again very calming and soothing for your skin. It's a good ingredient to have. My experience with this was not so good because it just took a lot of time to sink into my skin, which what I know because I make my own moisturizers and body lotions and eye creams, and I've done videos on it way back, I think last year. You could find those videos on the channel. I cringe looking at them because my video quality is so bad and I'm so nervous in front of the camera. So I myself can't look at those videos. If you can bear to look at those videos, please do. But those are very, very good recipes. Huh? So what I know from having formulated those products is that when there's an off between the oil balance and the fat balance in your product, you tend to make the product very difficult to absorb in your skin. And you tend to have a little more sweating when you use it. So I felt this with this particular product. But of course, it's not a very bad formulation. It's a good formulation. It's just that I have access to better. So I'm going to be using this as a hand cream. It's going to be sitting in my kitchen. Another good way to keep your skin bright and shiny and minus the tan is to just wax at home. I do it very regularly. I get the machine, the canister, and the strips from Amazon. I'm going to leave a link. Now, these machines don't last more than a year, but that's fine. It just costs you about 1,000 rupees or 1,500 rupees. But the cost benefit of doing waxing at home is tremendous. You can get a full arm, full legs for like 200 bucks. The can lasts you for almost about four times of full arms and full legs. So I do this once a month. I just feel that waxing is one of the best ways to exfoliate your skin. Just gets rid of all the dead cells. And it removes all the tan that builds up on our skin. I also shave my body. I don't shave my face, but I definitely do use a razor every now and then. And I use the Gillette razor, which has got some 30 blades on this. Queen of exaggeration. Two blades on this. But the reason I use this is because this is the razor that will actually give you the cut that you're looking for. The skincare industry knows that women love the color pink, they love the light pastel shade, so they're selling you a much more inferior razor with the pink and with those it just angers me so much. You know, they'll give those stripes over here which will kind of make your skin feel jelly and softness to tell you that when you're using the razor your skin will still feel smooth. That's such a load of bullshit, you know. What we use razors for is just to kind of cut the hair off at the edge, and you want that cut to be the nicest and the sharpest cut, which a man's razor will give you because they use this every single day and they use it for the best aesthetic appeal on their face. So I don't understand why you're paying more for a razor just because it's pink in color and getting inferior results in the end. Hardcore, high performance, great razor. This is going to give you high quality shaving results, which is what you want. It is so important that as you become familiar with this channel, you see more videos in this channel, you become a smart shopper. The first thing that you're going to take away from this particular video is to stop paying extra for the aloe strips and the hydration coming from your razor. You don't need that. You need a good cream to get the razor to glide smoothly on your skin. And post that, you just need to make sure that you're washing off everything. Basically, to prevent bacteria from forming or nesting in the fresh pores that you've just shaved off the hair from. That's all that shaving really is. So if you're somebody who's practical about such things, you might want to consider moving to the real stuff. With all the realness, I also want to talk about two products, which are just one of those products that you pick up because you're in the mood, you know, and aajkal tum kahin ja nahi rahe lockdown mein, but you know, I've had these for some time. And these are the products I used to use when I was in the mood to shimmer and, you know, to look great during my evening out with the girls or when I was just in the mood, you know, to just kind of shine and look very hoity-toity. So these products give you this massive glitter and shine. These are both from Bath Body Works. I have no idea how much they cost. If I'm able to find them online, I'll leave the links in the description box. But they are gorgeous, girls, especially when you have something nice and maybe even naughty planned. You want this to up your glam quotient. So with all the affordable body lotions that we've talked about, you know, it's completely fine to add something which is a little pricey, but really ups your mood and makes you feel very nice. At least it makes me feel very, very nice. We women are put under such a lens. Why is her arms looking flabby? Why is her skin looking dry? You know, why is she looking so not well put together? Why is she not looking glamorous? Why is she not looking pretty? In sabke niche, what really matters at the end is how are you with yourself? It doesn't matter how the world is judging you, but how do you feel yourself? Are you able to look in the mirror and say, wow, what a fantastic face you got? Yes, the cheeks are a little puffy, but that's fine, I still love you. And yes, the arms are a little flabby, but it's still mine. And I love you. Have you ever said that to your body? You know, the whole perception of beauty has made it so hard for us to look at our face in the mirror or look at a body in the mirror and say, hey, I love you the way you are. When was the last time you did this to yourself? Try it. It's really hard initially. It's very hard to look at yourself and say, I love my belly, I love my flabby arms, I love my puffy cheek. It is hard. But remember, before we expect the world to accept us for who we are, we have to accept ourselves for who we are. It is so incredibly important. Because when you accept yourself for who you are, what you stand for, what your beliefs are, and the way you look, you show that confidence to the world. And when the world sees that confidence, it thinks, isse panga loon ki nahi? And most of the time, they don't trouble you. And that is why women who are able to stand their place and are able to command the respect that they know that they rightfully deserve are generally women who are termed as difficult to handle, opinionated, rude, loud. When was the last time? That is the legacy that you and I are carrying. A man and a woman could behave the same way, but for the same qualities, a woman will be judged differently from a man. Can we change the whole world? We can't, but we can change ourselves. Let your daughters do what they want to do. Don't stop them just because you were told that girls don't do this. You know, if your mom expects you to behave in a certain manner because she was told that girls behave like that, you might want to keep her happy and do that, but develop your own personality when you go outside and when your own environment. Don't ever second judge yourself because you are told that you are lesser than who you really are. You know it in your heart, who you are, the power you hold, and what is the path ahead for you. Stay on it. Stay on it. Be true to yourself. It's only when you're true to yourself can you expect the world to even begin respecting you. For more, I'm going to meet you in the comment section.